My name is Mia Shem. 1 year and 1 month ago, I went with my best friend to a dance party. It became a bloodbath. Hundreds of young men and women were shot, dismembered, and others were brutally kidnapped to the tunnels of hell in Gaza.
As none of the resolutions to be voted on today address the suffering of the hostages, we shall be their voice.
It was shot in point-blank range when my arm almost detached from my body, hanging and bleeding. All around me, I heard screams of people being raped and murdered, while their butchers left.
Instead of denouncing the mass rape of women, the murder of children, and the burning of families alive, the statements heard in the past weeks in the Fourth Committee and today largely continue to ignore reality, and instead continue their obsessive focus on vilifying Israel.
Eliat Toledano, my best friend, was kidnapped before my eyes. I did not know that we would be murdered and I would never see him again. I was then dragged by my hair into a car with seven Hamas monsters who kidnapped me while shouting with joy.
Year after year, resolution after resolution, Israel alone is singled out, while the heinous crimes of Palestinian terrorist organizations are ignored.
For 50 days, I was kept alone, suffering from unbearable pain in my hand, without any treatment. A Hamas terrorist will sit in front of me in a dark room with a gun point at my head.
Of the 101 hostages, 13 are women who continue to endure the worst torture imaginable. Every day, every hour, every minute, and every second. Liri, Karina, Shiri, Agam, Daniela, Judy, Romy, Inbar, Ofra, Neama, Doron, Arbel, and Emily.
Not a single humanitarian agency saw me or treated me, even as my arm got worse. Where was the Red Cross? Where was the UN demanding that we have access to us?
None of the resolutions condemned the barbarity of terrorists, many of which are employed by the same agency under today's agenda item. No resolution addresses the threat of terror and its infiltration to a UN agency. The silence is deafening, and it speaks volumes.
On day 50, I was lowered into the tunnels of hell, where I was kept in a small cage with five other Israeli women. Two armed terrorists made sure we sat in the dark in silence. When I returned home, I needed life-saving surgery on my arm. It's been over a year, and the UN has not lifted a finger to free the hostages. You sit here in your comfortable chairs, demanding the lives of my friends as if they are political issues and not innocent people being tortured by terrorists. I ask you, why do we have even a United Nations if you won't stand for us in the darkness of moments? What good are your resolutions, your debates, your empty promises?
As Israel faces security challenges from Hamas, Hezbollah, the Houthis, and the Iranian regime, we continue to uphold our democratic principles and our humanitarian obligations. The resolutions to be voted on shortly dare to condemn Israel while ignoring Hamas's relentless cruelty.
If the sick, the elderly, mothers, and their children are left to rot in terror tunnels, I stand here to echo the cries of the 101 hostages who have now been in hell for over a year. Look at me. I am proof they can still be saved. In this moment, 60 meters underground with no air, no light, no hope, my friends are still being held by monsters. My heart is still with them, captive in Gaza. I stand here and demand that you bring them all home now. Just be human. Find some morality, find some courage, and speak up. Help us bring them home.
Thank you very much. The UN's complete moral failure is unforgivable. It is unforgivable that while Mia was locked in a cage alongside other women, none of the UN bodies, neither the Security Council nor the General Assembly, found the decency to condemn Hamas and demand the hostages' release. They have failed to meet this most basic moral obligation to this very day.
Hamas diverts humanitarian aid to fund its terrorist activities. Rather than addressing the real threats at hand, these resolutions are focused on perpetrating a distorted narrative that demonizes Israel and absolves Hamas of its crimes.
As the UN looks the other way, I make this promise to each and every hostage, to their families, and to the people of Israel. We will never forget you, never abandon you, and never stop until you are all safely back home.